Hello good folks of the Vinyl Community, this is Mike, PC31, the Vinyl Policeman. Quick video today, I just wanted to show you what I picked up on Record Store Day, which is very quick, there's only one, because I did very well in the main drop, but I've only picked up one today. Also wanted to show you two things I've picked up, which were both released yesterday. But first off, happiest 80th birthday support. In tribute, I'm playing McCartney 3 in the background there. So I'm having a bit of a McCartney day today. So the one and only thing I picked up today, which I wanted, was no great surprise to those who follow me, but it's the Kinks. It's the 12-inch Waterloo Sunset. So this was released today. It's a six-track EP, 45 RPM, yellow vinyl, which is really nice. Give me a yellow vinyl. Originally packed in just a paper sleeve, which I'm not keen on, so put it in there, but printed on the original Pye label there. But the six tracks, you've got Waterloo Sunset, which was released as a single in May 1967, and the B-side was Act Nice and Gentle. Also on this, you've got Mr. Pleasant, which was A side of the single in April 1967, and the B side is This Is Where I Belong. They also, Waterloo Sunset obviously was on Something Else from 67, and Holiday in Waikiki, Little Miss Queen of Darkness, they're both off the Face to Face album, and I don't think they've ever been released as a single in any format in the UK. But yeah, so all Ray Davies songs. Waterloo Sunset, which from a Rolling Stone magazine point of view, that's I think number 14 is in their 500 best songs ever. So Waterloo Sunset, Act Nice and Gentle, Mr. Pleasant, Holiday in Waikiki, Little Miss Queen of Darkness, This Is Where I Belong. The actual artwork they've used was from a French EP way back in 1967. 140 grams. Tony Cousins at Metropolis actually remastered it, so it's been remastered. It's the original production from Shall Tell Me, but it's been remastered. This is one of the delayed ones, which should have come out in the main batch of Record Store Day, but it's only just come out now. Mr. Pleasant was also released later on in the year 1967 as a B-side to Autumn Almanac. So it's a bit of a, you know, classic Waterloo Sunset, and then five tracks which I think are pretty much cult fan, big fan favourites kind of thing. So, but I played it several times already, and it sounds really nice on its yellow vinyl. So that's the only thing I picked up from a Record Store Day point of view. I had my eye on Bebop Deluxe and the Ramones box set, but at the end of also the Susie Quattro, but I haven't picked those up, not as yet anyway. But the things, a couple of things came out yesterday, I just wanted to quickly show you. And if you've already watched Richard McCook's channel, you'll know what they are. It's Ziggy. And, so they came out yesterday, so it's 50 years and a day after the original was released in 1972. Obviously just absolutely classic album from David Bowie. You all know the tracks, absolutely fantastic. So it's half speed. So half speed master from the original masters of the original, from the original Trident Studios master tapes, no additional processing or transfer. I think this is the first one so far which from a David Bowie point of view, it's been half speed mastered. So Paul McCartney's obviously going through that at the moment where he's had several come out so far. So this is probably the start of things in that respect. And the other thing, again, which Richard picked up as well, and I couldn't resist, is it's the same remaster, but picture disc, which is absolutely beautiful. Ziggy Stardust. Fantastic. And That comes with, let's quickly get it out. So that came with a poster, the original very, very famous Inner from this album. The very familiar Inner lyrics, and also a poster, which my wife's already told me she's going to pinch. Fantastic. So couldn't resist picking that up yesterday from wonderful David Bowie. Ziggy Stardust, absolutely classic, classic album. And the final thing just wanted to show you was also something which was, which came out yesterday, which I've got really mixed feelings about at the moment. The Smile, which is basically Tom York and Johnny Greenwood from Radiohead. And this is a little incarnation they've got, a little side project. A light for attracting attention, comprising Radiohead's Tom York and Johnny Greenwood and Sons of Kermit's Tom Skinner on drums. Limited yellow edition, yellow vinyl, so it's two records. There we go. Really mixed about this one. Fast play, found it. Pretty boring, if I'm honest. No real fantastic standout tracks. There's some things on there which I don't like at all. Vocoders being used on Tom York's voice, which is hideous. There's just nothing exceptional about this album for me. It's kind of, it's still very, very Radiohead, kind of as you'd expect. But the songs are not very strong. No, it's not doing it for me at all at the moment, so I should give it a few more plays. But I've played it a few times already, and it's pretty tedious, to be perfectly honest with you, so I can't recommend this one at all. Just my humble opinion. Others may completely disagree. And also, I mean, looking at some of the critics, I mean, most of the critics absolutely love it. It's Radiohead. Of course they would. But I think it's pretty weak. Not doing it for me. But that came out yesterday. Give it a few more plays, but no, not very good. So I had a very quiet record store day. Hope yours is a bit more productive, but I'm very pleased with that Kinks 12-inch. So till the next time. Thanks, folks.